Chapter 1, Variables and Scales. We're going to look at a few definitions, some descriptions, and some different types. First, an individual is the object under study. It doesn't have to be an individual person. It could be an individual object, like a car. It could be a hospital. It could be a drug. It could be anything. And so when we say individual, we mean the object under study, whether it's a person, place, or a thing. The variable is a characteristic of our individual. It could be age, gender, income, heart rate, and so forth. A measurement is an observation of a variable that is expressed as a number. Variable types are qualitative and quantitative. Under qualitative, we have essentially non-number categories. So we have like gender, where the two different options are male or female. We have color, where red, green, and blue could be the categories. We have class, which could refer to freshmen, sophomores, junior, and seniors. And so essentially, you're looking at grouping type variables, where the different values for each variable represent categories. Then we have quantitative variables, where the results are numbers. So, for example, the number of children in a family, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth, or body temperature by degrees. Under quantitative, we also have separation between discrete and continuous variables. The discrete variables are countable variables, meaning we have just a few numbers. So the number of children in a family, for example, are just a few different options, and they're all numbers. The number of cars in a household as well. The continuous variables are theoretically any number within a range. And so you could have distance in feet, where you have different measurements. And that distance in feet is between two points. It could be anything. Now, of course, our measurement scale, or our instrument that we use to measure the distance in feet, we may not be too precise, down to like a 1/100th of an inch. So the level of accuracy is definitely dependent upon our instrument that we're using to measure with. But we're looking for numbers within a range. Salary in dollars is another example, where again, it could be any value within a range. Test scores, height in feet, and weight in pounds. Those would all be examples of continuous variables. Variable scales we have. The types are qualitative and quantitative. The scales are nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. So you'll see that nominal and ordinal fall under qualitative, typically, and interval and ratio fall under quantitative. Now you'll see some discussion about ordinal and how that could potentially be considered quantitative or qualitative. But we're going to leave it here under qualitative. So with these different scales, there are different levels of specificity and information. So with nominal, we have our lowest scale, and ratio, we have our highest scale as far as detail. So in nominal, the numbers represent just groups or categories. The numbers don't represent magnitude. There's no order. And the assignment of a number to a group is arbitrary. So an example of that would be like male versus female. And so you have, okay, well, let's use a number 0 to represent female and number 1 to represent males. Well, we could have just as easily used a 1 to represent females and a 0 to represent males, because the number has no meaning to it and the order has no meaning to it. It's just two different categories. So when we use a number that has no order and no meaning other than to categorize, then it's considered a nominal scale. Ordinal is the same thing as nominal, but with the addition of order. So the numbers represent some sort of a rank order of the variable being measured. An example of that would be what grade you're in elementary school. First grade, second grade, third grade. Okay, so there's a specific order. I mean, second grade always comes after first grade, but there's not a specific magnitude. For example, you can't take grade 1 and grade 2 and add those together and get grade 3. or you can't add grade 2 and grade 4 and get grade 6. There's no specific magnitude involved. With interval, once we get to these quantitative values, we now do have magnitude. So you can think of qualitative variables as not representing magnitude and quantitative variables as representing magnitude. And so interval values are values that have magnitude of difference between the units represented by a number, but the place of zero is arbitrary. Let's look at ratio now so we can see the difference. Difference between units is represented by a number, and it also has magnitude, but now there's a zero that has representation of the absence of a characteristic, meaning zero now means something. So if we think of examples, interval, for example, we could think of year, like 2012 is a year. It's a number. The year zero would also be a year. But year zero doesn't mean that there's no year. Okay? So people living during the year zero, it doesn't mean that there was no time during that year. It's just an arbitrary point along the scale. And it's not even necessarily arbitrary, but it's just a point along the scale. And it doesn't mean zero as in nothing, as zero means for ratio scale. An example of ratio would be like money. If you have $0, you have no dollars. And so that would be a representation of ratio. Here's some more examples. We have nominal with gender, 0 equals female, 1 equals male. Ethnicity, you might see it with, 1 equals white, 2 equals Hispanic, 3 equals, you know, and so forth. And so the numbers are just placeholders. They're just grouping numbers. There's not any type of order or magnitude to them. With ordinal, now we have order, but still no magnitude. So college rank in football, you have first place, second place, third place, and so forth. But you can't take first place and add it to second place and come up with third place. Okay, there you can't really do mathematics of that nature with ordinal variables. A Likert scale, you have strongly disagree, disagree, neutral, and so forth. And so there's order to those in meaning, but there's not a specific magnitude. So for example, you can't say that the distance between strongly disagree and disagree is the same as the distance between disagree and neutral. The understanding of those numbers is a little bit different than what it would be for, say, quantitative variables. So for the quantitative variables, we have temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, where you might have these different degrees. And you notice that we have zero there. But a zero in degrees Fahrenheit doesn't mean a lack of temperature. It doesn't mean a lack of heat either. There would be an argument for Kelvin that zero supposedly means there is no heat. But for Fahrenheit, that wouldn't hold because there's still some heat even with 0 degrees. And so it's just some point along a scale. And so that's what an interval type variable is. And then we mentioned year already, that we have the years, and there could be a year zero, and it would not mean that there's no time at that point. It's just another point along the scale. Then we have ratio, which money in your checking account, if you have zero, then it means there's no money there. But then you can have other values where there is money there. Then distance traveled in a day could go from 0 miles up to some number. And zero actually means you haven't traveled anywhere. So it means no miles. And so it has meaning for that zero value, which makes it ratio as opposed to interval. And that is the end of Chapter 1, Variables and Scales.